What is up, guys? Coffee Break is back with another video, and the 2020 NFL Draft happened last night. The first sporting event in a very long time, and everyone was amped up. I know I was. A lot of surprising picks. The Green Bay Packers taking their quarterback, Jordan Love. That was the biggest surprise of them all. But the 49ers drafting a defensive lineman with their first pick, I think, is a big surprise. And why don't we start there? Javon Kinlaw was the first pick taken by the 49ers, and let's just walk through this first. Let's try to process what the 49ers are trying to do here. The 49ers originally had the 13th pick in the NFL draft. They traded their spot with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. They were slotted at 14th. Niners are slotted at 13th. They traded those picks and got an additional fourth round pick because of that. Now, the Bucs ended up selecting offensive lineman Tristan Wirfs, which I think will benefit them, giving Tom Brady some protection. I think the reason why it's a surprise for everybody drafting Javon Kinlaw, interior defensive lineman, played at South Carolina, the same college as Deebo Samuel. But I think the main reason why this pick comes as a surprise is because the people that they left on the board. For one, they left a very athletic offensive lineman who could, you know, slot in to play guard in Tristan Wirfs. Why don't we start there? They traded back a spot to pass on Tristan Wirfs, who, you know, would have solidified this offensive line, you know, would have filled in the hole in Mike Person being gone at right guard. So with the future of Joe Staley lingering on, we don't know if he'll be back, especially if we have, you know, uncertainty of how this whole pandemic is going to play out. There's a high possibility that, you know, Staley could just say, all right, you know, I played my last season already. So, they skipped on him, which gives me optimism that Joe Staley will be back this year. But then you look at the wide receivers that were left. At this point, Henry Ruggs III, who, you know, before the draft started, I zeroed in on Henry Ruggs. I thought the 49ers were targeting Ruggs. I'm very confident that Kyle Shanahan wanted Ruggs based on everything I was reading, just based on the player I was watching. That's how I felt. And I also feel like the Raiders took Ruggs away from Kyle Shanahan, which caused them to go to plan B. And I feel like this is plan B. They're not going to say it. I don't think they were zeroed in on Javon Kinlaw from the beginning. I do feel like maybe their guy got drafted a spot before theirs. That's kind of my reasoning with all of this. But even with that being said, Javon Kinlaw isn't a bad pick. That's not what I'm saying. Who they did leave on the board is outside of Wirfs, CeeDee Lamb, Jerry Jeudy. And so you have the elite wide receivers in my eyes, right? Henry Ruggs, CeeDee Lamb, Jerry Jeudy, and you skip on all three, well, all two, CeeDee Lamb and Jeudy, to go defensive lineman. Like I said, it's not a bad pick. It's more so a questionable one with the people left on the board. You could have easily flipped the positions they went with in terms of drafting defensive lineman first and wide receiver second, switch that wide receiver first and defensive lineman second, and still would have been fine. But Kinlaw gets drafted at 14th, and it tells me one thing. The mentality is keep the pass rush strong. And I think it will be strong. Kinlaw is a very athletic interior defensive lineman, you know, kind of looks like a linebacker, plays like one too. He's really quick off the ball. I like his game a lot. I just feel like when I was watching him on film, he is way too inconsistent. I mean, he's not polished. He's still a raw talent. But one thing that you don't need and that really sticks out on film is your hustle. How bad do you want it? That's kind of my question all the time when I play GM, right? But with Kinlaw, I don't see him go full speed at all times. That's my assessment. When he does, he's very dangerous. He can beat you off the ball. But is that consistency? We need to see that every single play. And I hope the 49ers coaches get that out of him. I feel like this pick is a little bit of a question mark still. Remember, you know, they're not going to say it, but Kinlaw's essentially trying to replace DeForest Buckner, an all-pro defensive tackle. So he has all the skill sets, he has the tools, but with this current defensive line group, the good thing is he doesn't have to be the guy, right? He just has to be a complementary piece to this already A-plus defensive line group. Nick Bosa, Eric Armstead, D Ford, DJ Jones, Julian Taylor. So the list goes on and on. The 49ers doubled down essentially on defensive line and said, this is going to be our strength on defense. And there it is. Javon Kinlaw became a 49er yesterday. But let's also discuss the second pick, because you remember the 49ers had two picks in the first round. They acquired wide receiver out of Arizona State. This is going to be, I think, the better pick of the two in my opinion. But Brandon Ayuk, first thing is he's versatile. He can play slot, he can play outside, you know, just every position as a wide receiver. And then you add the element of punt return, kick return, which has me thinking maybe Richie James is getting traded or something. You know, we'll have no use for him, unfortunately, now. But that's beside the point. Let's talk about Ayuk, who was actually left as wide receiver. I like him. I think he was the best receiver left when the 49ers were, you know, on the verge of picking. Just a prototypical Kyle Shanahan type of receiver. What I mean by that is he's not very tall, right? I think he's just 6 feet, if that. Is the quickness off the ball. He can run every route. I think Kyle Shanahan mentioned that in an interview. And then also a thing that stands out is his long arms. He has very long arms for his size, and that's going to help him going through the middle, running, you know, any type of fade or go route, is those long arms. So just a freak of an athlete. I think Brandon Ayuk is a great pickup. Again, you don't need a heavy number one. I've said that before. I still would have liked to see CeeDee Lamb, but the Niners made a decision beforehand. And I think at this point, getting Brandon Ayuk, I ain't mad at that. So with Deebo Samuel, with Trent Taylor, you add Brandon Ayuk, you add George Kittle. I think the 49ers had their wide receiver. I'd still like them to get another piece. You don't know the future of Jalen Hurd, who, you know, basically broke his back. And then Trent Taylor has had problems staying on the field. So I don't know. With a lot of rumors, Goodwin Pettis being, you know, shipped out, I feel like if that does happen, then the 49ers will have to draft another wide receiver. So I don't think they're done here in this department. But my only question mark, or my only issue with this pick, is that they had to trade up to actually draft him. He would have still been there at 31. You know, they essentially moved up, I think, 6 slots. They went from 31 to 25, I believe. They traded with the Vikings and gave up a 4th and a 5th round pick to pick up Brandon Ayuk. I feel like Kyle Shanahan really fell in love with him and just wanted him. That was kind of a questionable trade up, especially since you don't have any mid-round picks. You traded, you know, basically your only mid-round pick, your day 2 pick, your 4th rounder that you got from the Bucks to get Brandon Ayuk. I just feel like that wasn't necessary. That was being too aggressive. It kind of showed your hand that you really loved them. But I think Brandon Ayuk is going to be a really good player in the system. I also feel like, given, I know I wanted more draft picks, we all do, but that's because I know there's still a ton of talent left, and I just wanted the Niners to capitalize on that. In terms of trying to fill in another roster spot, you know, the only position I feel that we're in dire need now is probably corner and offensive lineman. I think that's who they will target. But in terms of the roster, I think the Niners are pretty good. I still feel like they'll need to get a little bit better. Hopefully with the next few picks, they'll, like I said, getting an interior offensive lineman who can start, who can fill in. I think that's going to be a key. But there you have it. Javon Kinlaw, Brandon Ayuk are 49ers. I want to hear from you. What were your initial thoughts when you heard Javon Kinlaw from Roger Goodell? And also, what are your thoughts on Brandon Ayuk? Go ahead and drop your comments below. I want to thank you guys all for watching this video, and feel free to subscribe. I'm here for all your 49ers news and needs. As always, you know, thank you guys for watching. We'll see y'all the next one, guys. Peace.